So in this lecture, we will discuss relations. First, we write the definition of a relation. A relation denoted by R from a non-empty set A to a non-empty set B is a subset of Cartesian product of A and B. Thus, mathematically, relation from A to B is a subset of Cartesian product ARB is contained in Cartesian product of A and B. If any ordered pair belongs to capital R, then we write small a is related to small b, and in particular, let us write an example. Capital A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Capital B is equal to 3, 4, 5. And let R be a relation less than from A to B. Now you see, so R contains those ordered pairs which satisfy this relation. So here we check the elements of A. 1 is less than 3, 1 is less than 4, 1 is less than 5. Similarly, 2 is less than 3, 2 is less than 4, 2 is less than 5. Now, 3 is not less than 3, 3 is less than 4, 3 is less than 5. 4 is not less than 3, 4 is not less than 4, 4 is less than 5. So this is a set which is denoted by R. Now let us discuss another example. Again, we have two sets A and B, and here the relation is a ordered pair with A belongs to capital A, small b belongs to capital B, and the relation is small a divides small b. So then what is the set R? So we all know R is a subset of Cartesian product. Now you see, we know 1 divides every number. So the ordered pair 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 6, 1, 8 will appear in this set. And next, 2 divides 4, 6 and 8. So 2, 4, 2, 6, 2, 8. 3 divides 3 itself. Now, 3 divides 6. 4 divides 4 and 4 divides 8 and 5 divide none of the number. So this is the required R. Okay, now we move further towards representation of relations. Representation of relations. So there are three ways to represent relations. Those three ways are roster form, set builder form, and arrow diagrams. So we will discuss all the three one by one. First, we discussed roster form. Roster form means relation is represented by the set of all ordered pairs belonging to R. So here in the previous examples, this R as well as this R are the representations of relations in roster form. Now second form is set builder form. Set builder form, in this method, the relation from set A to set B is represented by set in roster form, as you see this. For example, so we rewrite this as R is equal to AB, small a belongs to capital A, small b belongs to capital B, and A divides B, where A and B are the same sets that we have defined in example 2. So this is how we represent a relation in set builder form. Now third method is arrow diagram method. So this is the new one, because these two methods we already discussed in the definition of sets. Now in this method, we draw arrow from the first element to the second element of all ordered pairs belonging to R, relation R. For example, we have two sets A, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and let B is A, E, I, O, U. And let us imagine the relation that represents, that relates these two sets is 1A, 1E, then 2O, 3U. Let this be the relation. So by arrows, how can we represent these two? So we draw two oval shapes, and here is, this is capital A and this is capital B. We write 1, 2, 3, 4, and A, E, I, O, U. Now we draw arrows from the first element to the second element of the ordered pairs of R. 1 goes to A, then 1 goes to E, 2 goes to O, and 3 goes to U. So this is how we draw the arrow diagram of a relation. So now we will discuss a very important topic: domain, codomain, and range of a relation. So first we will discuss the definition of all the three. Let R be a relation from A to B, then set of all components of ordered pairs in R is called domain of R. So you see, first component is called domain of R, and the set of all second components of ordered pair R is called range of R, and the whole of B is called codomain. So for example, let R be a relation having XY having ordered pairs XY, then domain of R equals all X with XY belongs to R, and range of R, all the second components if x, y belongs to R. And if we have the sets R A and B, and whole of the B is called codomain of this relation. Now, to better understand this, we have another example. Let us take that we have two sets A and B. A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and B is 3, 4, 6, 8. And let R is all those elements, all those ordered pairs with A belongs to capital A, B belongs to capital B, and A divides B. So we can easily write R. How much is R? R is, now as we already discussed, 1 divides all, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 6, 1, 8. 2 divides 4, 2 divides 6, 2 divides 8. Now 4 divides 4, 4 divides 8. Also 3 divides 3, and 5 divides none of them. So this is the whole of R. So from this we can easily write, first we write the domain. How much is domain? The first component. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Range, you see, 3, 4, 6, 8. 3, 4, 6, 8. And what is codomain? That is again whole of B. 3, 4, 6, 8. Whole of B. So this is how we can have the domain, range, and codomain. So to better understand these topics, now we will discuss some numericals. First numerical is, we are given two sets A and B, and we are given a relation in set builder form. R is a relation having ordered pairs x, y, and the relation is difference between x and y is odd, where x belongs to capital A and y belongs to capital B. Question is to write R and R inverse in roster form. Let us try to write R. First we write those elements which relates this relation. You see, first pick the first element of A and try to relate it with the elements of B. What is the difference of 1 and 4? Minus 3, which is odd. So 1 is related to 4, 1 is related to 6, 1 is related to 9? No, because 1 minus 9 is 8, which is an even number. Next we choose 2. 2 is not related to 4, not to 6, but to 9. 2 are 9. 3 and 4 minus 1, 3 are 4. 3 are 6, because difference is minus 3. And how much is 3 and 9? Minus 6, which is not an odd number. Next 4, 4 minus 4, 0, not related. 4 minus 6, minus 2, not related, but 4 minus 9 is minus 5. That means the set in roster form is 1, 4, 1, 6, 2, 9, 3, 4, 3, 6, and 4, 5. So this also, we have been asked to find R inverse. So R inverse means we just interchange the role of A and B. Then this ordered pairs are also get reversed. That is 4, 1, 6, 1, 9, 2, 4, 3, 6, 3, and 5, 4. So all these elements are separated by comma. So which is the desired result. Next question, R is a relation less than from A to B. So first we express those elements which are less than. We pick elements of A, 1, and check whether it is less than 1, 4 or 5. So we directly write R here in roster form. 1 is less than 4, 1 is less than 5. 2 is less than 4, 2 is less than 5. 3 is less than 4 and 3 is less than 5. 4 is not less than 4, but 4 is less than 5. And 5 is less than none of them. So this is R, and we can easily write domain, codomain and range. First we write domain of R. The first components of the ordered pairs are, you see, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Range of this relation R. The second component, 4, 5. 4, 5, 4, 5. Only 2, 4 and 5. What is codomain? You know, all the elements of B. 1, 4 and 5. And next we have been asked to find R inverse. What is R inverse? We just reverse the elements of ordered pairs of R, that is 4, 1, 5, 1, 4, 2, 5, 2, 4, 3, 5, 3 and 5, 4. So which is the desired answer here? So let us now discuss some more numericals on relations. Find domain and range of relation R given by this relation. So you see, we are given a relation in set builder form. So we have to convert this into roster form or tabular form. So see how, what is the set here? What is the relation here? So this ordered pair belongs to R if y is equal to x plus 6 by x and x and y are natural numbers given x is strictly less than 6. We will have a clear idea. X is a natural number and less than 6. Then what is 6? What is x? 1. 2, 3, 4, 5. So these 5 values satisfy x. So from here we can clearly find y. For x is equal to 1, y is 1 plus 6 by 1. That is 1 plus 6 is 7. For x is equal to 2, y is 2 plus, which is a natural number here, we can write it also. 6 by 2, that is 2 plus, this will cancel, 5, which is again a natural number. For x is equal to 3, y is 3 plus 6 by 3, that is 3 plus 2, again 5 belongs to natural number. For x is equal to 4, y is 4 plus 6 by 4. You see, we cannot cancel 6 by 4, so which is not an integer. So this number does not belong to natural number. So next, x is equal to 5. 5 plus 6 by 5, which is again not a natural number. Then what are the ordered pairs that we get here? So R is x1, y7, x2, y5, x3, y5. So which is the answer in roster form or tabular form? And next we have to find the domain and range. So how much is domain of R? So we already discussed the first component of R, the ordered pairs of R, that is 1, 2, 3. And range of R, the second component of ordered pairs, that is 7, 5. So which is the required answer? Next numerical, A is equal to 1, 2 and capital B is equal to 3, 4. Find the number of relations from A to B. So here in this question, we have to calculate total number of relations that are possible from A to B. So for this, we again revise the definition of relations. So what are relations? Relations are subsets of Cartesian product. Relations are subset of Cartesian product. So for this we derive a small formula first. So let order of capital A is small p and order of capital B is small q. So that means number of elements in the Cartesian product. So we all know number of elements in A into number of elements in B, that is p into q pq. So again we also discussed the number of subsets. How many subsets a set have? How many subsets are possible? Now number of subsets of A cross B equals to 2 to the power pq. So that means this much relations are possible here. So in the given question, what is order of A? 2. What is order of B? 2. Then number of relations from A to B equals 2 to the power 2 into 2, that is 2 power 4, 16. Required answer. Now next question, R be a relation on integers as follows. Find R and R inverse and hence find domain and range. You see a relation is of this type, that all those integers for which a square plus b square is 25 will satisfy this relation. So we will try to write this. Okay, let us make a table of the elements which satisfy this relation. We write a here, b here, and a square plus b square is equal to 25 here. So what are those elements? So we first choose 0, 5. 0 square plus 5 square is 25. 0 minus 5, 0 square minus 5 square is 25. 5 0, 5 square plus 0 square is 25. Minus 5 0, minus 5 square plus 0 square is 25. Now after this, any other element which satisfy this? Yes, 3 and 4, because 3 square and 4 square is 25. 3 and 4, 3 square plus 4 square is 25, minus 3, 4, minus 3 square plus 4 square is 25, then 3 of minus 4, 3 plus minus 4 square is 25. Now we interchange them, or we first take the both negative, minus 3, minus 4, minus 3 square minus 4 square is also 25. Now interchanging, 4 3, 4 square plus 3 square is 25, minus 4 3, 4 minus 3, minus 4 minus 3. So that is minus 4 square plus 3 square is 25, 4 square plus minus 3 square is 25, minus 4 square plus minus 3 square is 25. So all these elements satisfy this. So the set relation contains all the elements 0, 5, 0, minus 5, 5, 0, minus 5, 0, 3, 4, minus 3, 4. This is the set R, and we can easily write R inverse just interchanging the elements. Here you will see that we will get exactly the same set. 0, 5, minus 5, 0, 0, 5, 0, minus 5. 4, 3, 4, minus 3, minus 4, 3, minus 4, minus 3, and then 3, 4, 3, minus 4, minus 3, 4, minus 3, minus 4. This is R inverse. Now we write the domain of R, that is 0, 5, minus 5, 3, minus 3, 4, minus 4. And range of R, again that is 5, minus 5, 0, 4, minus 4, 3 and minus 3.